last week on The Big Break Legacy.
Each team will be provided a range of clothing from which you would choose to put an outfit together.
It's in fashion right now.
Women's clothes is not my cup of tea.
The Nobel organization needs to flip and award me a peace prize.
You will not be talking to him. She will not be talking to him.
Business ideas and opportunities are everywhere, but it takes a certain type of person to spot them. It takes an entrepreneur, someone who can recognize an opportunity and turn it into a successful business. South Africa needs world-class entrepreneurs. The Big Break Legacy is going to find one. From thousands of hopefuls, 12 of the country's finest entrepreneurs made it through. From all walks of life, from all parts of the country. All with one thing in common, the drive and ambition to convince our three board members they should be the winner of a 5 million rand investment prize. The Big Break Legacy. Between Ify and Lolo, who stays, who goes?
You're leaving the show. Thank you for participating. We wish you well. Iftika, we're giving you a second chance.
I knew the golden boy would be saved. We knew we did not have up to scratch pictures to show. We knew if the team loses, I would be up there and he would get off scot-free, and he did. But karma knows everybody's address. If he will get what is due to him, when it is due to him.
If he arrives back, he survived to fight another day.
Oh, welcome back.
Thanks, thank you.
Can I get a hug?
Good. Come back. Some experience, yes, huh? Yeah. Shape with death.
Come back.
Thanks, bro. Yeah.
You don't look sharp, that you're back.
Welcome back, man.
It's not that I'm not sharp, I mean, like, it's just shocking things that happen in... Well, thanks, you know, it's just... Yeah, but I mean, it's the things that were said. There seemed to be a strong emphasis on me being arrogant and not giving anyone a chance to think or do anything. And I mean, there was significant haste. I mean, when Lolo was told to leave, I mean, she didn't even want to look at me, she didn't want to touch me. She says, you know, I made her look completely bad and I'm the reason of... I mean, I don't think I did any of that, you know what I mean? I don't know, if you guys should tell me, you know, in terms of feedback. How did I make...
I don't think you gave everyone a chance. I mean, we didn't even get to see the pictures, so...
But, Adele, come on.
We could have worked better as a team.
How was I supposed to give you pictures before I have them? You know, do you know that I stayed up till 3:30 this morning, making sure that I got every single picture that this guy promised me?
I don't know that, but what does it matter now?
At 12 o'clock. So, look, for me, it's a good experience, and you know, I think, I need to play a different hand of cards, I guess, yeah.
I don't think Lolo should have gone home purely because I don't think if he did his part as leader.
It happened, you know, now you've got to just move on to the next task. There's not much else I can do. I mean, now I've just got to keep working harder.
You guys well?
Yes.
Let's do this. Before I give you your next challenge, the board has once again decided to allocate you into teams. The Letsatsi Inc would be made up of Jared, Sanele, and Adele. Your Newton's fourth team is Iftika, Debucho, and Tepiso.
In terms of having a team that I actually believe in, I've got it. I think we'll take this one.
You'd be pleased to know that this is a charity task. What we want you to do is we want you to spread a social responsibility message. The message will have to be spread to a crowd by performing an industrial theater in the form of a flash mob. Each team will have to select a particular social responsibility task or theme or message from a list that we will provide you. You will then be responsible for developing your own concept as to how you can spread a message about this theme. Both teams cannot pick the same social responsibility message, and it will be left up to the teams to negotiate which is doing what. You also have 5 days to prepare for the performance. So the performance is going to be on Friday. Each team would be given 3,000 rands budget. You'd also be given an MTN in a business in a box. You make cars and drivers available courtesy of Chevrolet. And your judging criteria would be the effectiveness of your message, the response from the crowds, and your creativity. Will the blue chip from the last task please come forward? Zama, it was you, was it? Congratulations once again. You did well in the previous task. You now know what the teams are. You also know what the task is about. As an advantage for a blue chip, you get to choose which team you want to work with.
Okay, I'll go for Newton's fourth.
Newton's fourth. Newton's fourth it is. Good luck. Thank you. You may sit down.
I'm really happy that my team acknowledged my contribution by selecting me as the blue chip.
Dig deep and be as creative and as innovative as you can in terms of conveying the message that you have chosen to convey. Good luck, and as we always say, we measure you as individuals, but also as teams.
I'm looking forward to the task. I think it's going to be a nice one. I've got a very nice, compact team.
I think I've got a good team. They're willing to do everything to make it work. So I trust my boys. We're going to try and do our best with it.
Each week, one lucky viewer will stand a chance to win a Nexus 7 tablet by simply SMSing their name, number, and answer to a question coming up later on in the show. All entries throughout the season will go into the grand prize draw, where you can stand a chance to win a Chevrolet Spark. Remember, look out for the question coming up later on in the show, so stay tuned.
So who's the leader, guys?
I wouldn't mind being the leader.
Be the leader.
I'll do it.
Great stuff. Oh, I just came out from being a leader. let me this one out.
Yeah, the Queen of Kings is back. Now let's hope she does it like she did it before. We win.
Would be interested in heading this task. Would you?
Yeah.
I think so, Nene. Yeah, I'm happy with that.
All right, thanks.
Cool. I think we're going to work well as a team. I don't foresee any sparks flying. Jody's a bit sensitive to mind games and that type of thing, but you know what? There's no mind games. We need to win this. We need to win this task.
As much as we're talking about teenage pregnancy, I want us to give them that empowerment, that sense of, you know what, you don't have to prove to me by having sex with me that you love me, sure, or that I love you.
Being a virgin these days, it's not
cool.
It's not cool. Mm. So they say it doesn't show any dignity, it shows a lack of opportunity. So that's the mindset we have to change.
But now, what do we do?
I think we can't make that decision on the spot. We'll have to go do our research. Okay. And obviously it's going to be something big, something very huge.
Yeah.
But we need to get sponsors.
If we can really find expression to what we want to do and figure out the type of props we want to set up and how can we really showcase that without losing the syntax of the message, then that could work, you know.
How would we get the message across about teenage pregnancy?
I think it would be very effective if you were to have a lot of young girls with big bellies at a certain place.
I think we could be in a position to pull something together. More than anything, it's a chance for Ify to redeem himself.
In what approach are we conserving this environment? Are we conserving water, rhino, and things? Or are we conserving all of this combined?
Well, it's all of those resources. I mean, that all, like you said, leads to food security.
People misunderstand Adele and what she represents. Yes, she's melodramatic, I agree. But I do think there's some huge chunk of sense in her thinking.
So it's either we go big or we go home.
Big.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I think Joburg CBD, north to be precise. That's north, where every taxi in Joburg goes. Mm-hmm.
I've never seen a mob to start with in South Africa. How do you start pulling that off? So it requires a lot of thinking, a lot of creativity.
If it's rhinos that we do, yeah, have the university build us a rhino float with people inside and they just jump out do a coordinated dance.
Imagine a rhino giving birth, and it's giving birth to people on costumes.
Okay, that's a bit graphic, but it's a good idea. So Nene says a lot of things that I don't think he understands.
So who makes these girls pregnant? Is it their peers? It's not. It's us old people.
I think it varies depending on where you go, who these girls are exposed to.
It boils down to an individual. We can't shift the blame to anyone else. You have the right to say no.
For the purpose of not thumbsucking all of these things, let's go out, make the research, get the charity,
and then
understand what we're doing and bring this all together.
I agree.
Cool.
Is that agreed?
Correct.
All right, and I think it wraps it up.
Perfect.
Great.
We're going to do some epic stuff, so I'm excited to do this. I'm very, very excited to do this.
All right, guys. Okay. First of entrepreneurship.
100%.
All right, cool.
We're going to do our best. I'm working with most of the guys I worked with when I was the Queen of Kings before. We got a good chance of making it right. We've got a great team.
The Big Break Legacy. The Big Break Legacy is powered by MTN Business. Both teams begin the new day with their new task to stage an industrial theatre act to raise awareness of an important social challenge via a flash mob.
We are currently in Rosebank, so we should be in Houghton in less than 15 minutes. All right, thanks. We got actually a milestone of an achievement today. We got the Nelson Mandela Foundation as part of the plans.
So I just came from RLVA. They printed some of the poems that I wrote for the little girls to say during our flash mob. And the lady reckons they're very touching and they're quite great, and she got the message. So hopefully if I can get the girls to rehearse this and say it properly on the day, we'll touch many, many more hearts and we'll get the message across. Quite excited now.
So I stayed here, kind of trying to get all dance, you know, dance routine, dance groups and all of that stuff. We're looking to kind of raise awareness, you know, to conserve, like, you know, our land and all of that stuff. We're working with the Food and Trees Africa.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so it's...
Yeah, it's going to be harder to get dancers for free.
I need to have 20 T-shirts printed, okay? I've got a logo that I need to get onto it. And I need it printed by... And well, obviously ready by the end of tomorrow. Will that be possible?
Okay.
So one of our sponsors, the guys, the food sponsors, since they're contributing quite a lot of cash to getting everything done, we've arranged T-shirts to be printed with their logos on it. I got on the phone this morning, managed to sort that out, so we should have it tomorrow.
Thank you. Okay, bye.
What is it?
We got the intersection. We have the intersection. And I managed to get the traffic thing blocked off, Santon blocked off. So I'm very chuffed about that. That was the day started like that. Then we went to Mandela Foundation, Nelson Mandela Foundation.
We are intending to do this at an intersection in Santon, where we want to just stop traffic and see if we can get people to look at our message. The message will be in the form of a dance combined with some music.
So we all know that Madiba is passionate about us conserving our environment, and we can help wherever possible, and I'm sure that you'll be successful.
They gave us a book that had some of the quotes that Tata has used before, and we're going to be using the quotes as part of delivering the message out of the flash mob that we're going to do.
So just for those who don't know, here's what we want to do. We want to create a flash mob. And this flash mob is all about creating awareness for teenage pregnancy. So we're gonna do the flash mob at Pan African Shopping Center. So if you kindly just work with us, but also have fun, be in the spirit, you know? Everyone's gelling pretty well, I think. I haven't noticed, they haven't said anything to me, and I ask them regularly, guys, are you fine with anything? And they say they're fine, so they're adults. I believe they'll be honest.
So the happiness song does that, and then you guys start playing over it, and then there'll be no music, only you guys play.
They were gonna actually, you know, block, barricade the entire intersection where the Gautrain City is, and that was the new game plan. I'm just gonna continue with the choreography, and hopefully that ties in with the actual kind of location, because we are doing it on the street and not in a mall now anymore. So hopefully that ties in with my choreography. If it doesn't, I mean, there's some changes we can make, but it's not too, I think it's not too cumbersome or anything like that.
We will achieve
before we conceive.
Awesome, we're gonna get it right.
Newton's Fourth continue with their flash mob rehearsals at Zinto Activation Group Studios.
I don't want any touching. I want this to work for me. Yeah, baby. I like. You know what I mean?
While Letsatsi Inc take on more meetings.
Make people aware of why we need trees, mm-hmm. why we should be concerned about tree planting, and what Arbor Month is all about. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And this is a special Arbor Month for us because we've launched what's called the Trees for Africa Arbor Challenge this month.
Yes, that's exactly what we want to
do. On the website, yes. And it's like an interesting social media page where people are plotting their trees on Google Maps mm-hmm. and then interacting with each other and uploading trees. And we'd love to put some pictures of the flash mob onto the map and onto
yes,
this
sure.
whole,
actually lovely if
the whole site because you've got another 200. We can add your 200 trees you're giving away as yeah. another 200.
So you won't mind us putting that onto our little tag saying...
No, as long as I see anything, obviously brand and IP, I just need to check everything.
Of course.
And I'm the person, so you can just send it straight to me.
I'm very confident with the plan. We just need to put the theory into action. And I don't know. I'm worried that we're not going to have the dancers, but we're just going to have to make a plan.
We saw that the venue on the inside is small to get everybody practicing the routine. So we're sort of like hitting two or three birds with one stone. So we decided to let them come, at least here, and practice on their own to try and capture the routine while others on the inside are doing the same.
Letsatsi Inc. check out their potential location for their flash mob.
I have to either speak to Hartrain or to Santon so we can set up speakers here. Because the sound system's not going to be... This is a very big space.
It's not the easy way out. We would have selected any other place, but we chose that because understanding that it's very high risk and it truly says or shows the character of an entrepreneur.
I mean, other people, they don't, it's not in their dream that they'll be dancing with professional people one day and actually be on TV doing this. So for them, it's actually a big step. And I think it's an achievement that, you know what, we could give them that, you know?
In the course of the whole journey, you know, Adele somewhat comes out to be somebody who's very emotional about things. When it's her who comes up with something, it needs to work. But if any other person says we should do something slightly different, then it can't work. So that's a problem.
To get everyone to do the Macarena, I mean, you're gonna have arms going like this when some people are doing this.
No, but this is what's gonna happen. So they're gonna do their own stuff, like for 45
seconds.
Yeah,
and then they're gonna be doing the Macarena, which is what I think they shouldn't be doing.
There's frustrating things that we come across every now and then, but they shouldn't give us more frustration, you know.
This is going to be a mess. All I'm saying is, Macarena is a big risk. If you want to take that risk, I'm on it. It's fine. But then we need everyone there for rehearsal. Every single body that's going to be there.
I don't think Sonele has direction. It bothers me. He's not... He's here, then he's there, then he's here, then he's there, and he's very unpredictable.
The Big Break Legacy. The Big Break Legacy is powered by MTN Business. Final day of rehearsals and preparation dawn on the two teams. Letsatsi Inc. still haven't choreographed their flash mob.
Outside your place with that's made of bottles. Can we use that as a prop? Okay, thank you. Bye. Jared?
Yes.
That tree
yes.
is mobile.
We definitely need a proper tree though.
How's that tree not proper?
It's not a tree, it's symbolizing cans.
It symbolizes a tree. It's a tree made of bottles. It's
exactly.
a tree. Save our trees. It's the yes. perfect prop.
No, it's not.
It's fine. It's fine if she has that view. That's not gonna kind of affect my judgment or my character in any way. But it's definitely affecting the team.
Good morning.
Hi, today. How are you guys?
Good, and you?
I'm Angie.
Tepiso. Nice to meet you.
So we went to the Microsoft offices first in order to go to Web Shack and DAC Systems, which are the people who sponsored us with the banner and the graphics for the banner.
So this is really great. We have all our sponsors there at the bottom and our campaign message there and our campaign name right here in the corner.
Nice.
Guys, thanks a lot. Thanks a lot.
That's incredible.
Yeah, it was very nice meeting you guys.
It was very nice meeting you guys.
But we're busy trying to finalize our soundtrack. We've just added some few voices as well to try and chant the message.
So they decided for them to come back to the center of the stage and then they do the march.
It's already enough that we didn't have enough rehearsal time. So we had to do something that can help us to synchronize things together. And the best way you can do this is sound.
Hey, how's it going, man? Good.
Neville, yeah?
Good. How's it, Neville? Iftika? Ify?
Pleasure to meet you guys. Welcome to LXFM.
I didn't know that LXFM had 850,000 listeners. Also one of the fastest growing radio stations in terms of listenership.
Welcome, guys, to LXFM.
We're putting together a flash mob, and we're going to be showcasing it at the Pan Africa Mall.
I did a promo on radio, you know, promoting what we're doing tomorrow, which they've been running all day. Brought to you by SABC2, MTN, and Chevrolet.
What is this?
It's a tree.
A tree.
It's awesome, right?
A real tree.
This is a real tree made by children. It's beautiful.
I don't know what happened. Jared wasn't happy with the tree after he said it's the perfect prop. I went to go fetch the tree, basically pulled the tree out of my ass and had the tree here.
Be very careful. Maybe lie it on this.
It'll work.
Nice. Every time I get something, oh wait, Jared's going to do it better, and then it falls through. And then mine is simply still just a backup plan.
Newton's fourth, now check out their location.
Okay, Bansulas, we're gonna have the girls. Some are gonna be coming from here. So they'll be standing in front of this shop. The others will be standing in front of this shop. It makes sense for girls to come from fashion place. About 14. Let's just hope people will clear out our focal points when we start performing so that nobody gets trampled over.
We're waiting for the kids so they can come and do their rehearsal when the bell rings at 2. We've got about 50 kids, so it's definitely gonna work.
Finally, they begin rehearsals at Randburg Hoër School with students from all grades.
Okay, yeah. So guys, well, just hold on. Lumberjacks.
Jared has been leading the guys here, trying to lead them in. And Adele has been assisting as well with getting everybody on point. So yeah, it looks good. Our first run was good. Our second run is surely going to be good. Tomorrow it's going to be killer.
Cool. This is when the hip-hop dancers are going to come and they're going to shove you out.
Well, I wanted to rehearse more than once, and then Adele said no, they have to go. So, again, I didn't want to break the unity of the team.
We picked up t-shirts from Africa Tikkun. Another great experience meeting the ladies, understand what they're doing at this organization.
This is our campaign name and our campaign slogan.
Before you conceive.
So it's children of success, achieve before you conceive. And this is your logo, right?
Yes, it is.
Awesome.
It's a very beautiful logo.
Yeah, it is.
It's very, very beautiful. Yeah. Thank you so much. We really, really appreciate it.
Thanks a lot. Eh?
All right, thank you so much.
We really appreciate it.
We're going to get a tree because Adele's supposed to get a nice tree. And it was just a skeleton with cans on it, so it's not going to be very practical for our challenge.
I don't know what happened. Jared wasn't happy with the tree, so yeah, he got his way, whatever.
Adele never organized the tree. I've never seen a tree. I saw something that had bottle caps with colors. That's not a tree.
Why that instead of the tree that the kids have made, you know, it would make a great impact. So he had a real hissy fit and he refused to talk to me.
Yeah, so much for tree conservation, Jared. Plant them, don't hack them down.
You know, you go through all the motions, you know, everybody set up their meetings, you talk to everyone,
And you see how we've tied all of the irrelevant parties in our task, you know, and we've got people who are passionate about what they're doing involved. And it's really good.
Achieve before you conceive, that's our message. Children of success. So we involve the whole community.
This needs to be larger than life, guys. You've got to be big.
The tree issue creates massive tension at the house.
What do you mean?
Well, you know, who's exactly the one that said... I'm not going to give you the sensation you want. You know exactly what I mean. You finally got your way. It's done.
But who said that the other tree, who took it out and who threw it away?
It seems that she's always taking offense to everything everyone says.
You're attacking every person. Yeah. Every episode.
Back
every episode.
That's going to work.
I haven't back because people are already talking on it on Twitter that you're up there.
And Twitter is the universe. Not real life, Jared. I know Wendy's gonna ask me, and how did you work as a team? And then I'm gonna be the saying, oh no, it didn't work together. And then at the end, we pulled it together. It's the same line every week. Can you please come here? I was talking to you.
Why do I need to come here?
Because I want to talk to you when he's on the phone. Can I please talk to you?
Why do I need to come to
you? Oh, shame, Jared's innocent. Let's not talk to Jared.
She's a loose cannon. She must be tied on a leash, man. A very tight one. My behavior is just not right.
It's not the first time, we're not the first group that she's worked with where she does practically the same thing over and over again. Disruption just when we are about to get to the finish line. And this is not good for business.
I believe in magic.
Yeah, like I think it came out so beautifully. The lady who owns Zinto loved the final production that we showed her.
Hey, Ify, nice singing, man.
Boss! Hey, killed it. I know, it's coming out.
The lady from Zinto actually said the way she was touched by the message and how we did everything, she'd like us to go on a road show and go to all the schools in South Africa. So she's going to try and get us sponsors so we can do that after the show.
Troubles keep coming in.
Oh no, it's already so late that
we had a bit of a problem. At 5:05, the call comes in that the buses are no longer there. In fact, if we want the buses, we'll have to pay 7,200.
They say that the guys just can't do it on a sponsorship front anymore.
We were stressed because it's 5:00, the day's over, tomorrow's the show, we need to get people to the location.
We have a situation.
I believe we've lost our buses.
Yep.
Okay, what are we going
to
do?
We need to raise money to get those buses. We need to call around, check local.
At the moment, I'm calling a bus company to give us a bus for free. I've got two buses on standby because I don't know if his buses are going to come through. We don't have anything on paper.
We've been sticking up to her nonsense since the first day. She keeps on saying that she's doing things and she's not doing them. And we've been sticking up. We've been making sure that we try to bring her on board, but she's not coming on board. Every now and then she cries hysterical and she does not even do anything about it. So I don't think it makes sense. So for me, man, let's just stick
for
with
me,
what we, what
for
we
me,
do.
For me, I've had it. Like walking around on eggshells around Adele, expecting her to, you know, lose her flipper top and, you know, start swearing and all of that stuff. I can't work like it.
The Big Break Legacy. The Big Break Legacy is powered by MTN Business. Both teams make their way to the boardroom to present the final results to the board. Newton's fourth, present first.
Morning, guys. Take the opportunity to introduce Desmond Dube, professional actor. He's joining us to adjudicate on this task.
The main cause of teenage pregnancy is the social pressure, the media, and lack of self-affirmation. Possible solution, a communication campaign targeting young people and parents that asserts positive norms and highlights the benefits of being patient for sex. We created a campaign called the Children of Success. Our slogan is Achieve Before You Conceive. Now the Queen of Kings will take you through our implementation of our campaign.
With our flash mob, we wanted to tell a story. A story of how a child with a lack of adequate parental guidance can grow up to become a rebellious teenager. We wanted to involve the community, people within Alexandra, that could go back and tell others of what they have learned from our task. Now, I present to the judges our flash mob. Was given to all the organizations that we involved in our flash mob. They can use this educational DVD to teach others about teenage pregnancy should they have another teenage pregnancy awareness campaign. At Newtons Forth, we believe that the purpose of our lives is to add sustainable value to the people of this generation and to those that will follow.
What was the rationale behind choosing teenage pregnancy?
You're sort of encouraging people to go and educate themselves and progress themselves, you know, have children but do it at the right time. It also protects you from STDs and HIV.
Why did you choose music for this particular message? Music and dance in particular.
We wanted a contrast in order to highlight the message that we had, because had we just started with somebody coming in and talking, it would have been a few people listening and not really getting what she's saying. There's no guarantee that they wouldn't walk by. But with music, you know, they will stand and watch because everybody likes to see people dancing.
Well thought through, guys. Congratulations and well done. Okay.
Now, Letsatsi Inc.
Morning, guys. Who is doing your presentation? Won't you please start?
Good day to the board. As Team Letsatsi Inc., we chose the message for environmental conservation. One of the reasons was we wanted to create a high-impact industrial play that is socially responsible, that is able to tell a story on environmental conservation. So in selecting the intersection, particularly the location where we did our flash mob, we made it next to the Gau train station, where it could actually come to a person's mind after their frustration that I got stuck in traffic. Had I taken a Gau train, I would have possibly not been stuck in this flash mob. So that is another way of raising consciousness in people's minds. And now I present to you our flash mob.
Thank you.
call to action was very specific and straight to the point. Save our trees, because we need to save trees, we need to safeguard the environment. And that is what we took as our strategy, particularly in this challenge. We wanted to create impact, we wanted to maximize values, and we wanted to entrench the work that has been done by Food and Trees for Africa as our selected charity. And that is what we did in this task.
I'm worried though in terms of your chosen location. My thinking would have been that it would be best to stage something of this nature in the townships where there are no trees and really showcase the importance of having trees.
Why not, Santon? It's high impact. The type of people, as you say, that see that already know that, but they would be able to donate trees to Food and Trees for Africa to put into the communities that need it most.
Your presentation gives me the impression that you thought through the execution of the task. But looking at the evaluation forms, we get a different impression that you didn't work well as a team.
The responsibility that we took on was not only to hopefully win this task, but also to provide the charity with a message. And that passion translated sometimes into differences and sometimes even fights, but we got together and I say this every week, but we got together and we pulled it off, and I still can't believe we pulled it off.
As a driver, it can easily annoy me. And even if I was going to contribute towards this cause, you've already lost me.
Our intention was not to get 100 people pledged to the cause. We need one person to pledge to the cause because one makes a difference. And it might have been 10 frustrated drivers, but there must have been one who would like to listen to the message. And that's exactly what we wanted to target.
My sense is that there's quite a lot of planning that went wrong, as a matter of fact, and you could have maximized the impact of your message at the intersection. But be that as it may, thank you for your presentation.
I'm not sure in my own mind whether dealing with the issue of trees is as important as dealing with teenage pregnancy. So I'm trying to weigh in my mind which of the two social challenges would make more of an impact on society.
I visited both locations. The one location was almost, it was a frustration to get there. One, two, it was just so quick that it happened, and I don't think that there was a lingering effect on what it is that they were trying to do. It was almost like just a disruption of traffic, and therein for me was the difference between the two.
We need to have a look at, you know, which message lingers on. So yeah. Maybe we should call them in.
Yeah.
It's gonna be hard.
The Big Break Legacy. The Big Break Legacy is powered by MTN Business. Remember, you can stand a chance to win a Nexus 7 tablet by simply SMSing your name, number, and answer of the following question to 33614. What social responsibility message did Newton's Fourth choose? A. Environmental conservation. B. Teen pregnancy. Or C. HIV. Each week, one lucky winner will be selected, so SMS now. All entries will go into the grand prize draw, where you can stand a chance to win a Chevrolet Spark. SMS now. Both teams return to hear the results.
So the idea was that we put you in a situation where we expect of you as entrepreneurs, as you would find from time to time, that you need to think on your feet. You need to be innovative, you need to be creative about what and how you respond to the challenges that you'd be faced with as an entrepreneur. And of course, I mean, all of that boils down to proper planning and proper execution of your task, which is something that we, through this exercise, I'm sure you would say that you've experienced as individuals and as teams. You know, we don't want you to do the impossible. The tasks are carefully crafted such that we know that you can do them. And I mean, when you're put in a situation such as the one that you were put in, you were amazing in that it was very difficult for us as adjudicators to actually pinpoint the winning team. But there's no doubt in our minds that both teams have given this task their best effort, as it were. And you not being performers and not being experts in that kind of environment, we commend you for that. Des?
Well done, guys. The subject matters were totally different. The execution style was totally different. But we had to judge on which one of these two methods will carry the message longer. And the team that we all voted for is Newtons Fourth. Well done.
And for the blue chip, as you know, we identify an individual who has, according to the evaluations that we received, who has contributed the most to the task. And that was reflected in the evaluations that we received. So the blue chip for this task is Iftikhar.
Iftikhar. Well done, Ify.
Thank you, yes.
Well done.
You will get a significant advantage for the next task.
Sure, thank you.
Right. Can we ask the winning team, in this case Newtons Fourth, to exit, please? You know, guys, I'm almost irritated and disappointed by how you eventually executed the task, because I think that the sensitizer which you eventually had left a lot more to be desired. And I know that the message that you actually were conveying is so important. I think the other team beat you guys purely from a perspective of execution, and that left us to believe that the planning on your side had gaps.
The other team performed much better than us in terms of numbers, but not because we underperformed. It was like one person was just intentionally making sure that we don't hit the spot.
I'm not going to call two people. The entire team, all three of you, need to come up for review. You are all under review.
I'm quite upset that, you know, all three of us went in there, and it was because of Adele.
She's like a train wreck, just comes in there, pushes everything out of the way. It doesn't matter how it feels, it's her way or the highway.
At this stage of the competition, you're supposed to give it your all, your 110%, not 60%. 60% won't get you through. Jared, why should we still keep you in the show?
I really personally am shocked to be here. In each challenge, I've given more than my 100%. And that's all I can say is that even in this challenge, I gave my all. I gave my level best.
Sadele, why should we still keep you?
I led the team. We managed to execute. It might have not been meticulously as we had planned, but we did manage to execute at the end of the day. I have been consistent with my performance. I slacked at some time and I managed to pick it up because I noticed what I'm here to do. And I'm an achiever by birth, and I'm sure I can achieve much better than this.
Adele?
From the beginning, you know, I've put in as much as I could and more than is required. I'm a firm believer of doing that, put in more than is asked for. And in this task specifically, like I said, with charity being on the line as well, it was even closer to home, it hit home. So for me, I felt I did give everything that I could, and it may not have been good enough, but as a team, you know, that's where it fell apart.
I organized the sound, I organized the dances, I organized the intersection. Why was I there? Because I did that. Doesn't make sense.
The format of the show is around teams to remind you with each task that we expect you to bring your best contribution as an individual, but also we expect you to coordinate, to collaborate with the other members of the team so that you can have a much better outcome than you would as an individual. All research that's been done shows that the best effort of an individual is not as good as the best effort of a team of people. And that's really what we're looking for. So when you find yourselves here, it is because whilst we recognize your individual contribution, we don't see how that contribution brings out the best amongst yourselves as a team.
For me, ambush theater is one of the best vehicles that we can use to communicate quite quickly and effectively now. But it comes down to the teamwork that you guys don't have. It's not a team.
Yeah.
None of you mentioned that we you know, as a team, we've missed, you know, we missed the boat.
Yeah.
Do you get where we're coming from?
Yeah. Well, on that score, I'm afraid we're going to have to make a decision on who goes home. You've disappointed us as a board. All three of you let us down. And actually, I'm even of the mind of firing the entire team.
Ugh, it is what it is in Israel's words. I don't think I belong there.
Adele needs to be neutralized. And I think the faster other people get to also do the same thing, the better. We need to really deal with that attitude. It's not right.
With a three-way split, who goes home gets tricky. To see the flash mobs again, check them out on YouTube now. To discuss your favorite characters or team, go to #BBL2.